Hello everyone, this is Greyshot17 and I'm doing a quick video on where to get water if you don't have any. For context, for the last 24 hours I haven't had water, and so has a good portion of Texas. Not only that, but power. Luckily I do have power and I've been lucky enough to where most of the time it hasn't gone out. That being said, there are definitely other people I know of who live in Texas who have no running water, no power, no heat, nothing, and have had to go to other people's houses. And unfortunately, having to jump because then they don't return with power or water or anything like that and have to go at a hotel or another person's house. And it's just kind of escalating from there. Hopefully things return to normal, but the next few days it's still going to be very cold. It's still going to be possible ice. So I don't expect things to change all that much. I believe government services are closed, at least to some extent, for the next few days, and with more like special chain stuff like that kind of limiting their hours. And to be fair, a lot of people I know up north would be like, why didn't you prepare for this? For myself, even though I used to live in Pennsylvania and I do have some snow supplies, I don't have the snow tires anymore on my car, so I'm sliding all over the place. So that's unfortunate. And even if I did, the roads are so untreated just because there's nothing treating the roads, no salt, no plows, nothing, that you're essentially it's a layer of ice that's just forming on all these back roads and I'm assuming main roads, but I ventured out so I can't confirm that. But at the very least, I can say that I cannot leave my hill without crashing my car right now just because I slide and many people have slid across the road. So what do you do? Well, what I've been doing for water is quite simple. Go outside and I go to a hill. Now the reason why I go to a hill is because at least with this weather system that came in, a lot of the winds just press the snow in large groupings and then a layer of ice hit, which is great because then you can see areas that have been untouched. Plus with the ice, which has been around I think a half of inch, because it's been the first quarter inch and then another quarter inch that came in this morning from the time I'm recording, you can actually break apart. You need something heavy to break that apart and you get chunks. Fill up a pot or whatever you have that can hold a ton of ice and that can be heated up, or at least taken to a pot that can be heated up. Then take it over, heat up that pot, and you make enough water. Usually I think it fills the pot about halfway from how much, even if you stack it above, just again, how much you actually get for how much water is actually in ice. But I bring this up just because you melt it, you filter it, that way there's nothing bad in there. And also I say get the top layer because A, you can see if anything messes with it, and or any steps, any animals, anything like that. And on the other side, anything that's underneath the snow, anything that would be toxic or possibly harmful, would hopefully slide to the bottom of the hill. So if you get on the hill and you get the top layer that you know is untouched, then you should be relatively fine. Now I say this even though the main purpose I'm using this for is for toilet water. I'm putting in the bowl behind the main bowl. In that area can collect the water. That way I have a good flush, because at least that way I'm not worried about a smell while I'm not don't have any running water. We filter it and then of course we apply it with soap, or if we need to clean something, or if we just need to wash our hands and then put hand sanitizer over it. It's something, it's not great, but it's at least a possible water source that you can use. And especially right now, I don't have a ton of water that I can just so willy-nilly just keep filling a water bowl behind me with. And since I can't leave, I'm kind of in that current situation of, all right, I can't physically leave my house, but I also want to make sure that at least I have a decent water supply coming in to treat certain things. What do I do? Hopefully this kind of answers that question for you. Again, it's unfortunate that I have to make this video and water and power weren't at least rated for emergency situations. I know it's something that doesn't pop up or shouldn't pop up in Texas, but hey, you're gonna have that anomaly that pops up, so it's better to be safe than sorry in any capacity. Hopefully this helps you if you need some water. Again, I know it doesn't help if you don't have power unless you make a fire, which I'm not the person to go for on that, but at the very least, if you're looking for a stable thing, hopefully this helps you out and gets you some much needed supplies. So that way, at the very least, you don't have to worry about your toilet or your bathroom starting to smell. So, hey, a little survival tip for anyone watching this. And at least now anyone watching this knows what I've been going through the last day and a lot of what other people have been going through for even longer. It helps you guys out. Anyway, it's been Greyshot17 and I'll hopefully see all of you next time.